Shalom, my name is Raha Ernest, and we have been looking into those scriptures which will change the course of your life. And today we're looking into John 10 verse 10, and this is what it says: the thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. So Jesus is saying you shall not only have life as it is, you'll have abundant, overflowing life when you receive Him as your Lord and Savior. So what Jesus is saying also here is that the devil will do one of these three things. If you do not have Jesus, you will have the devil coming after you. And he will do one of these three things. He will either kill, he will either steal or destroy. So you can put all the problems facing the world at the moment into those three baskets: either killed, stolen or destroyed. There's a lot of things that can be stolen from you. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is your strength. If the devil wants to steal your strength, he will steal your joy. You see a joyless person, you can be sure that their strength is taken from them. But the main thing that the devil steals from you is your identity. That's what he came after when he came to Eve, Adam and Eve, in the Garden of Eden. He said to Eve, has God really said you shall not eat this fruit? Because when you eat this fruit, you'll be like him. You'll know good and evil. But the Bible says in Genesis 3 verse 5, they were already created in his image. They did not need to try and be like him. The devil came in the same way to Jesus in Matthew 4 verse 6. He said, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, down this cliff. Because God said he will give his angels charge over you. But he did not need to prove his identity. He was already the Son of God. So the devil will come after your identity. And what does he come to kill? He come to kill your vision. The Bible says in the last days the young men shall see visions. And what does he destroy? He come to destroy your image. The Bible says in Colossians 3 verse 10, talking about we have, in 1 Corinthians also chapter 2 verse 16, we have the mind of Christ. We are created in his image. In Romans 8 verse 29, similarly. So we are in John 10 verse 10. That's a scripture for today.